Hey guys, this is Mirachit Jain, and today I'm back with a video on second year internships. So this video will be split into two parts. In the first part, we are going to talk about why should students do second year internships in software development, of course. And in the next video, we will be covering how can students find summer internships after second year. All right. So why should exactly students do software engineering internships after second year? This has two phases, both pros and cons. So as you can see in front of you, you can see the pros and cons list. I will quickly go through them one by one, okay? And then later on in this video, I will tell my personal experience, what did I do in my second year internship and how did I feel about it, okay? So the first pro that comes to my mind for summer internships is, of course, the experience and exposure that you get. So when you're doing internship in a company in software development, be it any language, first of all, it's not expected that students who are coming just after second year must know completely about the technology. They're given the chance to learn, but it's obviously recommended that you should learn that beforehand. Like if you're applying in a company like Flipkart, so you should first learn some Android or maybe their website. So HTML or JavaScript or Angular, whatever it is, whatever their website is based on, you should learn about what technology is being used in that company and only then apply for that. So anyways, you learn experience and exposure, which is really, really important. It enhances your resume because you are adding something official. Some organization is getting added up in your resume and that counts. So that's good. Plus, the exposure is important because you come to know what is the kind of life that you will once be into once you graduate and join a company as a software engineer. It might be different for different companies, but still you get some of the, there are common similarities present in all of the organizations. That's about how things work when you're a software engineer, and that's what you can observe. So that's a really strong point. Then second, as I mentioned, resume, I have covered that again. And the third is money. Yes, you earn. That feels good, right? And I think that's really good. Coming to the cons. So look at this. You get 2 months vacations or whatever you get. But after that, what happens? Third year begins and now companies will be visiting to your campuses for hiring for internships. And they don't care about what did you do in your second internship. Okay, they don't care. Even if whether you have also done it, they might, but the major shortlistment is done on the basis of your data structures and algorithm skills. And if you have not done competitive programming, or if you have not done Geeks for Geeks, or you have no idea about that, then it will be really difficult for you to get shortlisted. And if you're not shortlisted, then you cannot even tell or showcase your work or the learning that you got in your second year internship. So make sure that you, if you have never touched anything about data structures and algorithms till your second year, I would suggest you should not do second year internship. You should focus those 2 months purely on problem solving skills, logical reasoning, enhance all those kind of skills, practice on code forces, Geeks for Geeks is really good because a lot of the questions that company asks for internship or even for jobs, those questions are somewhat related to Geeks for Geeks questions, and you also get to know the level of the questions, and it's not really that hard if you are doing a computer programming. So that matters. So one of the cons is, you will be spending a lot of your time in the internship, so you can't find much time for data structures and algorithms. That's one negative point. And companies don't care much about second year internship, as I've mentioned. So this is the pros and cons list. And now I will be covering my experience. So I was not having any thoughts of doing second year internships, and frankly speaking, I was not that great. It had been around 4 months into competitive programming. I was doing great, but I knew that I'm not up to that mark. First, I was from electrical background, so I knew that if I have to do really well, then if I have to get in a really good company, then I must outstand the other students. Otherwise, I won't even get into the notice. So, but anyways. And I also wanted to live closer to my family. I applied in a company called Grofers. I don't know if you have heard about it. It's similar to the Big Basket concept. It delivers groceries within 90 minutes of time, and you can schedule deliveries about vegetables and groceries. That's the concept. And it was just opening, and it was covering Delhi and Gurgaon. So I did 2 months of internships over there in Android development. I learned a lot. So I really learned a lot of Android development. Within just 2 or 3 weeks, I learned an awful, awful amount of skills over there. So once I did that, I felt really good, but the timings were really restricted over there. So it was both mixed emotions, I would say. Then other pros is they gave every intern Mac, and it felt really good. It was my first time that I used Mac, and it was awesome. I really loved it. Then obviously you also tell your friends, and they and the reaction, again you feel good, right? So the third benefit of working in Grofers was stipend. They give 25,000 per month for second year internships, and that's awesome, because even some students do not get that amount even during their third year internships. So that's really cool. I really appreciate that. Then exposure, man, that's really awesome. I came to know what is it to work, what does the environment of a software engineer looks like. I felt that, I faced that, I got frustrated. And coming to the cons, as I was having mixed emotions, as I've mentioned before, I couldn't spend much time with my family, and that was, you know, that was eating me inside a little bit. And I just thought, with like, why am I doing this? Do I need this? And I also had my learning. I learned in the first 2-3 weeks itself. So I did quit twice during working for those 2 months in Grofers. And the first time I did was because I was just amazed to see a senior member. He was like really pressing me that why am I not on time or something like that. So their working policy was that I should work from 8 a.m. till 8 p.m., 12 hours. And that really sucked, because I can't work like that. And Game of Thrones was coming during that time, and all of the employees were watching that. Not all, but there were a lot of people who were giving me the episode via Mac drop. So AirDrop, that's what I think what they call. So yeah, I know that 12 hours no one can work. And I directly told that if you're pressurizing me like this, I can't work in such environment, because I won't be doing justice. And I don't want to waste my time. I don't want to sit over here and watch episodes and episodes. I can watch a single episode, but I can't do anything after that. So yeah, I really got frustrated. I was not that mature to handle that situation properly, I would say. But yeah, that's important. I got this learning. I got this experience that how it feels to be frustrated, and how you can respond to that. After joining Microsoft, I have changed a lot, and that I will cover in some separate video. But yeah, this is a really good pro or positive feedback that I take from working in a second year internship. The second con that I mentioned was about the data structures and algorithms, that you can't do that much practice. But it's not really like that. I was able to shuffle my time between that. So as I've mentioned, I can't work 12 hours on the Android work, whatever that was. So what I did was midway after doing the work, if I had some extra time, I used to do data structures and algorithms over there. And it was during the internship time only. It was May challenge or June challenge, I don't remember, that I got AIR within 10. So I got a code shift t-shirt. I solved all the 10 problems. That was the first time that happened to me within 6 months of my journey in computer programming. So yeah, it depends. It's really not that difficult to manage time. Yeah, I might have to. I learned time management. I will take it like this, that I learned time management. I did a lot. I learned a lot. And to get to the next level, you have to stretch a bit. But I feel I had the energy, and you should try this. So in nutshell, you should do second year internships. It's really good. It really helps to learn a lot, to get the exposure. So you guys should definitely try for second year internships. And about how do we get internships in after second year, because companies don't come to hire second year students. So that will be covered in the next video. So stay tuned. I hope you like this video. So please like it and share it with your friends. Thank you. Bye.